Hello and welcome again. This is Robert Schein, Managing Director and Partner of Blanke Schein Wealth Management. Today is December 3rd. It's a Thursday. We're getting closer to the weekend. And thanks for watching my daily updates as we're going to go through the topics of the day, things that markets are paying attention to, so we should too. So thanks for watching. First topic of the day, inching closer to a deal. There are rumblings out there in the last 24, 48 hours in the news cycle that each side, both Republicans and Democrats, and sort of the leadership from both sides are inching closer to a deal, meaning the CARES Act 2.0 or coronavirus relief aid package. $900 billion is sort of the landing mark right now. The President-elect Biden administration has already endorsed this by saying it's not the deal, but it's close to a deal in terms of it'll do for now, which means what the market sees from this. Ultimately, there's a $900 billion package that could get done over the next, call it 6 weeks, potentially, who knows. But what has been hinted and signaled, if you listen carefully, is it's a start, right? And so the Democrat leadership that is going to be in full force in 2021 is looking at this as just a placeholder and a starting opening bid, if you will, of getting this one passed and ultimately teeing up another bill potentially going forward. Now, ultimately on the short term, let's see how the Congress actually settles up with the Senate and see where the control of power actually ultimately lies. But that just then says that there's closer of an opportunity of getting a deal done now, sooner than later. We'll see how this all plays out. Don't hold your breath, as I said before. But the reality is that there's small businesses and those travel industry and a few others and those that are unemployed that really need that assistance. So while they think it's fun and games and politics, they need to check themselves right now and really get to work, as they're not even in session as we speak. So ultimately, they need to actually start working for the American people and get to something sooner than later. Our second topic of the day is on the heels of the first topic. The first topic is there's a stimulus coming. Second topic is inflation and what that has to do with markets. I'm actually going to go a little bit deeper, not only today, but on future episodes of my daily updates. I'm going to go deeper on this simply because this is what's driving markets and why they're going higher. The first topic I talked about, why it's relevant, what markets are paying attention to. Additional stimulus will be in the hands of consumers. Those consumers, two-thirds of our economy, based upon the GDP, gross domestic product, are consumptions, right? Where Americans don't know the definition of enough. And if you give an American a dollar, they won't save, they will spend. So that's the formula that the markets are paying attention to. That's why equity markets are going up every day, because corporations are going to be capturing those dollars. Now, these are hard times, right, for corporations. And so they have to do everything they can to, you know, continue to survive, if you will. And even though that 5%, less in terms of the third quarter total reporting, there was only a 5% decline. If you look at all of the S&P earnings in the third quarter this year, and that is related to the travel and the entertainment industry. If you strip that out, corporate earnings actually grew for the third quarter, but they're still going to survive, right? Going to have to figure out how to survive in the new environment. Well, the reality is that they figured out they can go direct through the consumer, which is online spending, and we're seeing that. And by the way, UPS and FedEx just said today that if you want your stuff delivered, you better order sooner than later, because they can't keep up with the demand. So that's empirical evidence right now to actually literally show you that there is people are consuming, right? But what's inflation have to do with it? Well, here's what's happening. Corporate America is doing two things, and I put them on the board. It's economics 101. Inflation is in what we consume, right? There's going to be inflation when we go to sort of events next year. Talk about if we start flying again and when we start flying again and go to that concert. There can't be the same number of people. So half the seats for the distancing that's required at any event in the future is going to require an inflation in ticket prices or inflation in all of the activities that we're going to look at. So travel and leisure are going to have to make up for the loss that they had with half the amount of people traveling. It will happen. Mark my words, we will see inflation all over. But we're also seeing inflation from our cereal boxes to our ice cream on a daily basis. Corporate America is not dumb. They're figuring it out that they can take an ounce away, still charge the same price, and you and I are still buying the same goods and ultimately services out there, but they're taking away some services. Let me give you an example. The next topic is more with less. My wife just was at the pet store, right, buying dog food for our dogs, right? And so she's in line, and there's a huge long line right now at every store you go to once you're in. And so she asked the clerk at the counter, you know, why is it that we wouldn't have an extra, you know, support staff to help you out because you look a little bit overworked? And he's like, ma'am, I've been trying for weeks to ask corporate to hire more people, but corporate's unwilling to hire more people. Well, that's interesting because we've got 11 million people out of work in America right now. But corporate America is waiting for, one, it's uncertain. We don't know how coronavirus will continue to go going forward. So I understand that. But mark my words on this, and this happens every economic cycle. This is Econ 101. Corporations lay off, right? The number one cost on a balance sheet for corporate America is labor. They lay off, they do more with less. So that checker has to do twice as much, and you and I are conditioned to wait and be patient. Customer service is gone. It's left the building in 2020 because we all have to go slower and we all have to expect more in terms of patience as it relates to anything that we're doing in goods and service. Rightfully so. I'm not disagreeing with that. But what I'm saying is wait and see next year. Corporate America is going to be slow to hire. Why that matters is that dollar that keeps coming in, as proof by the third quarter GDP and all the third quarter reporting of all corporate America, they're still being able to make money, both by you going to them or they going to you by way of delivering those goods and service that you ordered online. And that dollar is going to work its way in the balance sheet, but the balance sheet for the corporation is doing substantially greater financially speaking because of the labor. They're doing more with half of the staff. Again, that guy who told my wife, he's like, listen, I wish they would hire more people because then we can actually serve more people. But we can't because corporate America is not hiring again. That's going to be the key that the market is paying attention to today in the future for future earnings. Okay, so markets are going up on a daily basis. Keep in mind, corporations can make money in using these little maneuvers, and it's economics 101. So markets paying attention, as we should too. But that's one of the reasons, little tricks that corporate America plays as it relates to reducing their balance sheet costs. That dollar then starts dropping to the bottom line. Again, shareholders benefit. So that's your update of the day. I'm going to drill down deeper on this and on future episodes. And thanks for watching. Like and subscribe as always. And we'll get more information for you, what markets are paying attention to. Therefore, we should be too on a daily basis. Take care. Have a great day.